Welcome, dear students. Today's session we are going to discuss about purchase consideration. What is purchase consideration? It is the agreed amount which transferee company, that means the purchasing company, pays to the transferor company in exchange of the ownership of the transferor company. So in simple words, whenever a purchasing company purchases the business of some other company, purchasing company is supposed to pay some amount to the liquidating company. So that amount, it is called as purchase consideration. This amount the purchasing company pay to the liquidating company in the form of cash, shares or any other asset as agreed between both the companies. Now we'll see what are the different methods we have for calculating purchase consideration. First one, we have lump sum method. So compared to all other method, lump sum method is the one of the simple method to calculate purchase consideration. In this method, when transferee company, that means the purchasing company, agreed to pay transferor company a fixed sum of money. So in this method, it will be directly given the purchase amount given by the transferee company to the transferor company. So you can see the example here. XYZ Limited agreed to pay ABC Limited 25 lakhs. This is lump sum method. This example is directly given the purchase consideration amount, and students no need to calculate the purchase consideration. It will be directly given in the question. The second method, we have net payment method. In this method, purchase consideration is calculated by adding all the payments made by the transferee company, that means the purchasing company, the shareholders of the transferor company. Transferor company means liquidating company. Payment can be in the form of cash, shares or debentures. In this method, we are calculating the purchase consideration by adding all the payment made by the purchasing company to the shareholders of the liquidating company. So we will get the value of purchase consideration. But we have to be noted some points. First one, value of asset and liabilities taken over by the transferee company are not to be considered while calculating purchase consideration under net payment method. Also, liquidation expenses paid by the transferee company should not consider. Amount paid to third party by the transferee company also should not include while calculating purchase consideration under net payment method. It is very clear, amount paid by the transferee company to the shareholders of the transferor company. The third one, we have net asset method. Under this method, the net asset value is calculated by deducting all the liabilities taken over by the transferee company from the entire asset taken over the transferee company. You can see the formula here. Purchase consideration equal asset taken over minus liability taken over. So in this method, you should be clear with the term asset and liability. The term asset include all the asset including cash, but we won't consider the fictitious asset. So we will take the goodwill also unless otherwise it is stated. The term liability means it include all the liability towards the third party. It is very important, all the liabilities towards third parties. But if it is a net payment method, the payment made to the shareholders we are taken into consideration. Here liability means liability towards third parties. So this is the way you can calculate purchase consideration under net payment method. We'll move to the last one. We have share exchange method, also called as intrinsic value method. In this method, you can calculate the purchase consideration using the following formula. So purchase consideration equal net asset available to the equity shareholders divided by number of equity shares. So these are the most important four methods for calculating purchase consideration. I'm expecting this topic clear for everyone? Thank you so much.